Hi, welcome to part three of the video series, Telescope Basics. My name is David Fuller, host of the Eyes on the Sky weekly stargazing series that can be found at eyesonthesky.com. In this video, I will explain the basics of standard eyepieces used in amateur astronomy telescopes. The first thing to know about eyepieces is that your telescope is only as good as the eyepieces that you use with it, though you don't need to spend a lot of money to get decent views either. They come in 3 barrel diameters. Even if one of them is largely not manufactured anymore, the 0.965 inch ones, and the popular 1.25 inches and 2 inches. You can easily use adapters to fit smaller eyepieces into larger focusers, but it's a bit more difficult to go the other way, though 0.965 adapters for 1.25 inch eyepieces do exist. So why do we have different eyepieces and different barrel diameters for them? Well, in the prior video, we learned about focal ratio. Shorter focal ratios allow telescopes to be shorter. What that also does, though, is make the angle of the light cone much steeper. So larger eyepieces are often needed. Otherwise, part of that light cone vignettes or gets cut off, usually due to focuser tube diameters. Vignetting is not a good thing because it effectively reduces the aperture of your telescope. And the larger your aperture, the fainter objects you can see. No sense in reducing aperture unnecessarily.
That would be dumb.
So the 0.965 inch eyepieces were used in long focal length telescopes because they would not vignette the shallow light cone. They could also be for simpler designs. Christian Huygens developed one of the first true eyepieces that used 2 lenses to focus the telescope's light, unlike Galileo, who used a single lens. A simple design, the Huygens also has a narrow field of view, often just 35 or 40 degrees. These are often designated with an H on the top or side of the eyepiece. A similar 2-lens design is the Ramsden, usually signified by an R or SR on the eyepiece. Because of the simplistic 2-lens focusing setup, they are adequate for short focal lengths in long F-ratio telescopes. When made well and paired with longer focal length scopes, they can perform pretty well, but most current offerings are done inexpensively and unfortunately placed with short F-ratio telescopes, which means they often do not provide good views and therefore produce a lot of optical aberrations. A somewhat better design is the 3-element Kellner eyepiece, offering a slightly wider apparent field of view of 45 degrees. It also does a better job of correcting some of those optical aberrations of slightly faster telescope designs. It is usually designated by a K on the eyepieces. The Edmund Scientific Company took that design, flipped it upside down, and called it an RKE. Mead did something similar, terming it a modified Achromat, or MA. Though simple in design and inexpensive to make, they do perform quite adequately in F8 instruments or longer, though the apparent field of view is somewhat restricted. But the real breakthrough is the 4-element Plossl, today's workhorse standard good eyepiece. With a 52 degrees apparent field of view and good optical correction for aberrations, even in somewhat faster telescopes, these are an eyepiece that can be used in most any telescope, and it will work fairly well. They're not terribly expensive, and in mid to longer focal lengths, they also offer good eye relief. Wait, eye what? Yeah, eye relief. That is the distance you can place your eye away from the lens and see the full field of view in the eyepiece. And the problem with all of the eyepieces above is that the shorter focal length, the shorter the eye relief is, until you get situations like this. And if you wear glasses, this can be even more problematic. More exotic types of eyepieces have therefore been developed with 5, 6, and sometimes 9 or more lenses, occasionally making for very heavy and large eyepieces as well, that can be used in very fast telescopes, have good eye relief, and with enormous apparent fields of view, but correspondingly, they also cost quite a bit more too. One thing to look for in lesser eyepieces is to be sure that all of the lens elements are coated with anti-reflection coatings. At minimum, a layer of coatings, and ideally, every lens surface will be multi-coated. Expensive eyepieces will have the standard. The lower cost the eyepiece, the less likely all lens elements and all sides of all lenses will have those coatings. So those are the basics of eyepieces. Now in part 4 of this video series, let's take some of the knowledge from these previous videos to understand apparent and telescopic field of view in the next video. And also, would you like to see what's up in the sky this week? Look for the weekly sky videos at eyesonthesky.com. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up.